Well, folks, welcome back to Smuggler's Adventures. Today, I'm going to be taking you to the Disneyland Resort again. And I'll show you where the best spot to view the fireworks is in the resort. So come along with me on this adventure.
Mrs. Incredible, Spider-Man, Enlightenment.
Look at the window displays. They are gorgeous. But anyways, the best time to come to Disney, even though I like the morning times or sometimes the day times, it does get a little hot, but honestly, I think I would probably preference coming to Disney at nighttime because all the lands glow with all their lights and it's honestly the best. Plus, you have nighttime shows, which is going to be fantastic, which is one of my favorites. Also, too, the castle has the fireworks show. But yeah, hands down, I mean, it's a little more busier, so you do have a lot more of the day guests going home and a lot more night people, a lot more people coming towards the nighttime. But honestly, it's probably the best time to come. Is during nighttime. Hands down, the best Disneyland snack. You do have a regular pickle for $3.99 or a spicy pickle for $3.99. I want to grab a spicy pickle. Now, the castle is one spot you can watch the fireworks at to see the fireworks and the projections, or if you just want to see the projections, you would head over to Rivers of America right here in front of Pirates Caribbean Haunted Mansion. After Fantasmic, they do put up the water screen, so you could watch the fireworks from here too. But I'm going to show you guys the best spot to see the fireworks if you guys really don't prefer the projections or the music, if you just want to see the fireworks. So I'll be showing you that. But first, I think we're going to be getting on the Haunted Mansion Holiday. I truly love the wallpaper on this ride. I mean, the wallpaper, the gift wrappings, hands down, my favorite thing about, well, everything about this ride is my favorite. The best part of the attraction. Oh my god, if you guys can actually smell it, it smells like real gingerbread house. A real gingerbread. My favorite.
Are you ready?
Oh, we're stopped again.
We will continue our holiday.
And the man himself, Jack Skellington. Whoop whoop!
Happy holidays, everyone!
And his love is looking right at him. Look at. I believe they added Sally back in 2019 or 2018, so she's still fairly new to the Haunted Mansion Holiday. Ooh, Boogie Boogie being generous. Let's see what gift we get this time. How generous. I got a stick of dynamite. Or sticks of dynamite. Ooh. All right, so as you can see, the castle and the hub area usually fill up the fastest. And after that, the next thing to fill up is actually going to be Main Street. So if you do care about projections and the sound and seeing a few of the good view of the fireworks, you could do this, but I'm gonna show you the best spot to watch fireworks within Disneyland at nighttime. First, what you wanna do is head into Frontierland. Once you get to the end of this pathway, which is going to be where the Columbia ship is and the Mark Twain, and also where Thunder Mountain is, you're gonna make a right, go down that pathway. Once you get to this point where the Mark Twain and Columbia is, you're gonna make a right, like I said. You're gonna go down another pathway. Now, you're gonna bypass Big Thunder Mountain and you're gonna keep on walking straight and just keep on walking down that pathway, which is the Big Thunder Trail. I'll show you where we're going. Now, as soon as you get to in this pathway, instead of going all the way down, you're going to see a sign that where it says Fantasyland, an arrow pointing that way. Instead of going that way, you want to make a left and go down this pathway. Now, it's going to look like we're going nowhere, but honestly, my preference is probably the best spot to watch fireworks if you're really not into the music or the projections, because where the fireworks launch are pretty much on the backside of Disneyland. And where I want to show you right now, you're actually pretty much almost right under it, but not right under it, if it makes sense. So yes, we're actually going to be heading into Star Wars Galaxy's Edge. And at one of the tunnels right here, they do have a lightsaber car. I believe the lightsabers are $43 after tax. So that's something to look forward to if your young ones want something to glow. But yes, we're walking to Star Wars Galaxy's Edge. Now, straight ahead, if you look at that building right there, that's actually going to be Droid Depot. That's where you're able to build your own custom astromech unit, either a RTD2, a BB-8, or a chopper. And there are plenty of options that you could do too. Let's check out Joy Depot before we head to go see where the best firework viewing area is. And right outside of it, it's going to be this little sign. So it's going to say Market. It's going to be down that way. Spaceport, which is going to be where you're going to ride the Millennium Falcon, and the old outpost, which is the Rise of Resistance, where one of the best attractions come at this resort is. So here's going to be the inside of the droid shop. It's going to be one of the rooms that's in here, and behind here are the droids. So you could hack those droids if you choose to. And what's cool about this store is that inside they actually have droids inside of cages they can look at. Then another cool fun fact here is in here, you're going to see droid parts going around like on a conveyor belt. If you see them, there is a pattern to them. I believe the pattern is 1138. So I believe that's going to be George Lucas's first film. So it's kind of like a little hidden secret within Galaxy's Edge. Let's see if we can try to find it. So let's see, here's three. So here's eight pieces. So it's going to restart right here. So if you see this blue leg, it's going to be one space, one space, then three pieces right there. So you have the yellow leg, the red arm, and like the C-3PO body part, space, then eight pieces in a row. And it actually makes that pattern five times. So that's a cool little hidden secret within Galaxy's Edge. It's paying a little like homage to George Lucas's first film, which is 1138. That's pretty cool. But yes, this is actually where you're going to be able to build your own droid. There are 14 build stations, so if you did want to build one, there is plenty of rooms, and you would actually pick your droids from this conveyor belt right here. So there's all kinds of parts you can choose from, so yeah. Then right here above the belt, there's actually going to be little monitors to show you the diagram of all the parts that you could build and on majority of all the options that you do have. Then this sweater right here is hands down the most comfortable sweater within Disneyland. It's like a French terry fleece, so comfortable, and it does run a little big, so if you want like an oversized sweater, hands down the best sweater. And if you come across to this wall right here, there's actually gonna be these new backpacks. I believe these came out about 2 weeks ago, then after tax, they actually come out to $64.64, so it's actually not that bad, and they do hold a lot of stuff inside of them, because they are meant for the droid, so they are actually meant to have a lot of room. So I did buy one in my backpack. I do from time to time I will bring my either my laptop or I have a laptop or a backpack organizer, so I'll keep my laptop, iPad, and all my chargers in there, and it still has a lot of room. So actually very good backpacks. But here you go, here's going to be all the droids that you could build. So this is going to be the BBs. You do have your motivator right here, all different style of domes, the bodies, and here's just some of the variations that you can build a droid. Then on the other side of this cage is going to be your R series, or RTD2, and your C series, which is Chopper. And now all these parts are interchangeable, especially the domes, the little Chopper domes, like this one right here, this one up here. They actually come with little side arms, which is really cool. Then here's going to be all the bodies that you could get. Now Chopper body does come in like kind of like an off-white and a blue, as you see right here. Then Chopper's legs also come in like an off-white or blue. And my favorite thing about having the style is that now it comes with a little center leg, and this center leg or center wheel is actually interchangeable between the R series and the C series. Now, that's actually one of my favorite transitions. But yeah, so when you come through that tunnel, just keep to your right, keep on walking. And we're gonna go past this little transmission tower. If you're wondering where the restrooms are, actually there's a restroom spot right here too. So right down this pathway. And keep on walking. And once you get to end it right here, this is probably one of the best spots to watch fireworks. You do have the Blue Milk stand right there. Plus straight ahead, you have Docking Bay 9, which is all for the First Order. So honestly, this little piece right here is probably the best spot to check out fireworks or to watch them. Why? Because it's open and literally fireworks launch up in the skies right here. So I probably would grab a snack or something to eat and probably come relax and wait for the fireworks to start right here. Sorry it's a little dark, but honestly, I would say Galaxy's Edge is probably one of my favorite lands. It's not like any other land that they have in the resort, as everything looks nice, clean, pristine. In Galaxy's Edge, everything looks worn, beat up, and it has a story behind it. And I think that's one of my things I love being in this land, is that knowing that this land already has a history behind it, not just its land. So if you look around, everything has a purpose, or maybe it's just, I don't know, there's something about that I really like. Like, if you look at the buildings, like, right here, I don't know if you probably tell, but even on the buildings, even the, like, within the Star Wars universe, those things on the side of the building, they serve no purpose, but honestly, I believe they're called Greeblies, and it's just to add that little aesthetic to it to make it seem like it actually does something, or like it actually serves a purpose, but in reality, it actually serves no purpose. It's just more for the looks and to give you more of the effect that they have within Galaxy's Edge. Now, truly, I know I am going to be doing more tours on, or more showing you around the outpost, but at nighttime, I say the market is the most beautiful spot within the resort. All the lanterns hiding, and if you look in every single shop, always look up, because there's details from the floor to the ceiling, especially in Outfitters, which is right across the way right there. If you're fluent in your Arabic, there's a tag that leads Al Khawarizian. So if you know who that is, it's actually, technically, you would say he's the owner of the Millennium Falcon, but yeah. As you can see, we're right before the fireworks, and it's not that busy at all, so this is honestly the best spot to check out the fireworks and have a good viewing area. So a little fun fact is that Disney actually launches their fireworks right behind Galaxy's Edge, and also too, Disney tends to use compressed air to launch their fireworks, so that's why sometimes when you see a fireworks, they're just automatically there. They technically don't want you to see the fireworks going up, they just want to be there, so that's why I think that's what makes it more magical here, is that knowing that the fireworks are already there when they go off. As you see, here's gonna be a print, like a good example showing that this land, it's not new, it looks worn and beat up. Like you see right here towards the end, it actually has a kind of like something's chipped away compared to this side. Oh, by the way, this is for the First Order. We don't like the First Order. David, woo! Oh my god, it's so dark! Well guys, that's it. That's going to be it for today's adventure. I do have social media out now. I do have a Twitter and an Instagram. I will link those down below. So if you guys would like to follow, the information's down below. And like I always say, I'm here for a good time, not a long time. Stay safe out there, friends. Oh, and one last thing. If you like today's adventure, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell button. So every time I upload a new adventure, you guys will be the first to know.